Hey guys, I'm Isil Khan, and in this video we'll be learning about the height or vertical distance determination by using an angular instrument. And this instrument can be theodolite, Ibn Lewal, or any other instrument. Okay, so this means the method I'm gonna explain over here is the same for all types instruments which can measure the vertical angle. Alright, so let's see. I got a tree which height is to be determined, and let's say I got an instrument which can measure a vertical angle. Let's say this is a theodolite, okay, sit at point A. Alright, so once we got a theodolite at point A, then we'll measure the distance between point A and point B, which is the distance between an instrument and the object which height is to be determined. This time we got a tree, and this can be done by using a measuring tape. Okay, it's so simple. Let's say we got this distance is 100 meters. After this, when we measure the distance between point A and point B, then of course we'll set the top of the tree like this, okay, and the vertical angle must be noted. This time let's say we got this vertical angle is 60 degrees. Now what should be the height of the tree? Okay, it is just the summation of h1 plus this little portion, okay, which I'm gonna discuss little late. All right so as you can see, we got a right angle triangle over here. All right like this one, it is a right angle triangle. Now it's all about trigonometric ratios. If you remember, the tangent of the theta must be the perpendicular divided by base. Okay, it is a trigonometric ratio, and here we got the perpendicular is h1 and the base is this distance, which is the distance between this tree and this instrument. So the only thing we're gonna do over here is to plug in chug in. Like, as you can see, I need to work out h1, so I'm gonna multiply d to both sides, so I can get h1 equals d times tangent of 60 degrees, and d is known over here, which is 100 meters. So I'm gonna plug the video of d over there, which means we got h1 equals 100 times tangent of 60, and it is of course 173.2 meters. I'm not done over here, okay, because this little portion is still remaining. This means we're gonna work out h2 by using a measuring tape. Okay, it is so simple because it is a small video, so we can do it by using a measuring tape, or we can just add the height of instrument over here. That's so simple, nothing complicated over here. All right which means the total height of the tree is now h1 plus h2, and these both are known, so we're gonna add these both together. That means the total height of tree is now 174.7 meters. And that's it, that's so simple. And of course, one another thing, as you can see, the distance between the instrument and the tree is so simple to measure it by tape. What if we cannot access this bottom of the tree? Or what if we have a mountain? Mountain is never accessible, okay? So for that problem, and for the solution, or for an example about that guy, we just need to wait for the next video.
Thank you dears for watching. See you next time. Hello, salam.